We've said that when we're describing the shape or geometry of a compound, there are two systems that we use. There's electronic geometry and there's molecular geometry. This first one that we're going to look at is the electronic geometry. We're going to say that this one is known as the simpler geometry. So electronic geometry can also be called orbital shape. And what we need to realize about the electronic geometry is it doesn't discriminate. It treats lone pairs and the surrounding elements around my central element as the same. So lone pairs and surrounding elements are both treated as X. And we're going to say our central element is A. Using this system to identify different groups in your structure will make it an easier way for you to memorize the different names associated with this structure. Okay, so if we take a look at this compound, this made up compound, we have AX3. A is our central element, so we're going to say A. Then we're going to say it has three surrounding elements around it, and it also has a lone pair. So we're going to treat the lone pair and the surrounding elements as the same. So we're going to have AX4. AX4 would be the electronic geometry of this compound. And all you'd have to do is come down here and realize if you're AX4, then your electronic geometry is tetrahedral. And your AX4, because you're surrounded by four different groups. Your central element is surrounded by four different groups. Now, these different groups can be in different arrangements. So let's go through each of these. If you're AX2, that means your central element is surrounded by two groups. Again, those groups could be a lone pair and a surrounding element, or two surrounding elements. So here, carbon's our central element A, and it's surrounded by two of these surrounding elements. Here, central element is carbon, and it's surrounded by two elements. If you're AX2, your electronic geometry is linear. Now, AX3, this would mean that your central element is connected to three groups. Here, we have boron, which is A, our central element, and it's surrounded by three surrounding elements, so it's AX3. SNF2, SN is the central element, A. It's surrounded by two surrounding elements and a lone pair. Remember, we treat surrounding elements and lone pairs as the same. We treat them both as X. So we have three groups, so AX3. Here, nitrogen surrounded by a lone pair and three surrounding elements, AX4. Carbon here would be AX4. Here, if you're AX5, your electronic geometry is trigonal bipyramidal. So here, xenon is in the center. It's surrounded by two surrounding elements, but it also has three lone pairs. We treat all those groups as X, AX5. Phosphorus here would also be AX5. Here, xenon would be our central element A. It's surrounded by four elements, and it has two lone pairs, AX6 and sulfur AX6. What I want you guys to realize is, remember, electronic geometry doesn't see a difference between lone pairs around the central element and surrounding elements. It treats them as the same. As long as you can remember the AX system of labeling things, then it becomes that much easier.